Good morning, students. I hope everyone is doing fine. Stay safe and healthy at home. Don't go outside. Even if you want to go outside, follow all the safety measures. Make use of this time for your studies. Concentrate on your studies well. You may have your second monthly exam very soon. So prepare well. Concentrate on all the subjects. Attend your classes regularly. Submit your assignments regularly. Now in the last class, in the last week, we have started with the lesson with organization of tissues, and we saw plant tissues and animal tissues in detail. Last class we completed with the fluid connective tissue, muscular tissue and nervous tissue in detail, where we draw the structure of neuron which belongs to the nervous tissue, which is very important, I told you already. Today we are going to see the final part of the lesson, which is cell division. So it is in the page number 219 to 222. You can refer your textbook. Okay, first we want to know what does the cell division mean. So we all know we are all made up of cells. So our life, the life of every living organism, start with the small cell, and we may wonder how this single cell is going in form a large organism like us. So how it is forming? All these are reproduced by division, and division of cells into daughter cells we call it as cell division. And there are three types of cell division you can see here. One is a mitosis, which is the direct division. Secondly, we have mitosis, which is the indirect division, and meiosis, which is the reduction division. So we are going to discuss them one by one in detail. First we have is a mitosis. So if you see, this is the simplest mode of all the cell division, and it always occurs in unicellular animals, aging cells and in fetal membranes. So during this a mitosis, what happens? The nucleus first elongates. So can you see here? This is the nucleus. It starts to elongate. The nucleus will first elongate and the constriction appears. So after the elongation, the constriction means, can you see a small curve here? It is given a constriction. So small bend part, we call it as constriction. Constriction and it which deepens and divides the nucleus into two. So this constriction will go very strongly and then divides this nucleus into two daughter cells. So this is, we call it as a mitosis. Next is another two kinds of cell division are mitosis, which occurs in somatic cells, and meiosis, which is the reason for creation of another new sex cells, which mean creation of another new human being. Okay, so now if you take this mitosis, first we are going to discuss this mitosis in detail. So this was discovered by Fleming in 1879. So here the cell division, in the cell division, one parent cell divides into two identical daughter cells, each with the nucleus having same amount of DNA and same amount of chromosomes and genes as the parent cell. We call it as equational division. So we call them as equational division, and they occur in two events. One is karyokinesis, other one is cytokinesis. So if you see here, what are the reason for this mitosis are? This is the reason for growth, repair and healing, and asexual reproduction. So this mitosis is main reason for growth, repair or healing, and asexual reproduction. First we need to understand what is the somatic cell mean and germ cell mean, because we'll be using these words throughout this part. So we need to understand the meaning of this vocabulary. So somatic cell means it is a body cell, a cell whose genes will not be passed on to the future generations, which means those genes will not be passed on to the another generation. Next is general cell. It is a destined to become a gamete, a cell whose genes can be passed on to the another generation so that new baby will be formed. So somatic cell, you have to remember, those genes will not be passed on to the future generations. But if you take the germ cell, here the genes can be passed on to the future generation. Next, another vocabulary is diploid and haploid. Dip, di means two. Dip means two. A cell with two chromosome sets in each of the cell, we call it as diploid, which here it always occurs in somatic cells only. Next is haploid, which is only one. A cells with one chromosome set in each of its cell. It is like sperms and eggs. Here haploid can be seen in sperm and eggs. That is in mitotic cell division we can see this. Now we need to understand what is this cell division. So during mitosis, what happens is the nucleus of the cell divides, forming two nuclei with identical genetic formation. So you can see here the nucleus divides to give identical genetic information. So this mitosis can be taken place in five steps. What are the stages? Five stages. So here, what are the stages are? First is prophase, metaphase, anaphase and telophase. So you can see here, first will be the first one. The remaining four are prophase, metaphase, anaphase and telophase. So we'll discuss one by one in detail here. Before starting the prophase, we have the interphase. This interphase is actually the resting phase of the nucleus, which means the cell is getting ready for the cell division. So under karyokinesis only, so I told you, know, there are two events. One is karyokinesis, the other one is the cytokinesis. Under karyokinesis only, all these four remaining four phases you will get, like prophase, metaphase, anaphase and telophase. So if you take this prophase, what happens here? The process of the cell division begins here. That is, the chromosomes get condensed, which means the chromosomes, they become very short and thick. They become completely visible inside the nucleus here. And the centrosome gets splits into two. And the centrosome split into two and occupies the opposite sides of the four poles. So this is how the nuclear envelope disappears, and they become, you can see the the chromosomes are visible. Can you see a small thread inside them? That is, they are the chromosomes. They are becoming visible inside the nucleus. And then the centrosome become split into centrioles and occupies the opposite sides of the poles. And then each centriole surrounded by asterase. Each centriole is surrounded by the asterase. You can see here, this is the centriole. This round pink color dot is centriole, and these green color lines are the asterase. So each centrioles is surrounded by the asterase. And then what happens? The spindle fibers appear between two. So you can see the dotted lines going between them. So they are the spindle fibers. They start to grow in between them, and the nuclear membrane and nucleolus disappear gradually. So what happens? The nuclear membrane and the nucleolus, they will be disappearing. So this is what happens in prophase. What happens first? The chromosome, they will become short and thick, and they will start to visible inside the nucleus like this. Afterwards, the centrosmere will split up into two, so the opposite sides of the poles. So you can see, you know, both the sides, they will split up into two. Then afterwards, they will be surrounded by the asterase, and between this asterase, you can see the spindle fibers getting developed. So this is what happens in the prophase. So if you, this is the diagrammatic part of the prophase. This is how you will be drawing. Next is the another vision. Actually, this is the like animated form, you can say. This is how it looks. You can see the spindle fibers, centrioles, then the sister chromatids are here, and this is the centromere. Centromere means in the both the sides of the chromosome, the center part, we call it as centromere. Next is metaphase. So what happens in the metaphase is these duplicated chromosomes. So in the prophase, we had got, no, these duplicated chromosomes, they will start to arrange in the equatorial plane of this metaphase plate. They will start to arrange in the equatorial metaphase plate. Each chromosome get attached to the spindle fiber. So you can see the spindle fibers here. These lines are the spindle fibers. So each chromosome will be getting attached to the spindle fiber of by its centromere, through which it will be getting attached through its centromere. What is the centromere actually? So the centromere will be looking like this. So for example, this is the structure of your chromosome. The center part, we call it as the centromere. Is it clear? So this is what we call it as centromere. Through that centromere only the spindle fibers will be getting joined. The centromere of each chromosome, they divide into two, being associated with the chromatids, and they will, what happens, they will get divided into two. So on the half of the side, they will be getting divided into two. This is how they look. Next is anaphase. In this anaphase, what happens is that the centromeres attaching to the chromatids, what happens? They divide the daughter chromatids of each chromosome separate and migrate towards the opposite poles. So this is how your chromosome is looking, no? This is how your chromosome looks with the centromere. So in anaphase, what happens? This part separately and this part separately will go and attach to the opposite poles. Can you see here? They are attaching to the opposite poles. They get splitted up into two chromatids. Okay. So this is how they look. So this is how they will be arranging in the opposite poles with the help of the spindle fibers. Next is telophase. In telophase, what happens? Each chromatid, they start to lengthen and becomes thinner and turns out into a network of chromatin threads. Spindle fibers will get broken down and they disappear. And nucleus membrane and nucleus reappear in the daughter cell, which means those chromatids, they will start to grow up. They will start to grow and they will be breaking down the spindle fibers. So these lines are the spindle fibers, no? Those will be started to broken down and new membrane and nuclear membrane and the nucleolus will start to generate. So this is how. So initially they will disappear in the prophase. While coming to the telophase, they will be generated again. And the final step is the cytokinesis. So in cytokinesis, what happens? The cytoplasm will start to divide into two, giving two daughter nuclei, two daughter cells. By constriction of a cell membrane, we call it as cytokinesis. And what is the significance of cytokinesis is that this equational division results in the production of diploid cells, which mean two cells, and it also helps to repairing the damaged and wounded tissue by renewal of the lost cells. Already we have seen that. Next is, we are going to identify now, like, what are these stages involved? Do you remember? First stage is what, children? In the mitosis, can you remember the name? Can you name the stages now? First stage will be your prophase, then metaphase, say along with me, then anaphase, telophase, finally cytokinesis. So in the prophase, the nuclear, the chromosome, they become short and thick and they will be clearly visible. Can you see? They are clearly visible inside the nucleus in the prophase. And in the metaphase, they will be arranging in the equatorial plate. As you can see here, they will be metaphase plate. They will be arranged with the help of the spindle fibers. And in the anaphase, the chromosomes will break down into two chromatids like this. So initially, they were like this. In the metaphase, they will be broken down into two phases, two chromatids like this in the anaphase. In telophase, what happens? They will start to grow a new nuclear membrane and nucleolus. They start to grow up and the spindle fibers will be completely broken down here. In the cytokinesis, the cytoplasm will split up into two and give two daughter nuclei. Is it clear? So these are the different steps you can see here. So interphase is always the resting phase, which means the nuclei, the cell is getting ready for the next cell division. Next we are going to see meiosis.